Hello everyone. Today we have another user request about an InDesign tutorial. We're looking at this situation today. As you can see in the table of contents, we have the country name included to the actual recipe of our cookbook. And we're going to see today how we can remove those that only the recipe name gets included into our TOC. We're going to use some variables in text. We're going to look at the running header feature and also take a look at our table of contents. So let's get started. As always, you find the link to download the sample document we are using today in the YouTube description of this video. Let's take a look at our TOC. Those lines here are actually the headlines of our different recipe pages, so the ones you see here. And if we look into our paragraph styles, we see they have the paragraph style header applied. So at the moment, we have the country name, spacer between them, and the actual recipe name in one line, and therefore it's going to be completely picked up by the TOC and included completely. Our goal is now to just get the country name from the page before. We have always the spacer pages in between, and then we would only write in here the actual recipe name as a headline. As you can see here, we also have the recipe name in here already. So you would be asking, well, I just can include this one here into the TOC. But let's just imagine, for sake of this tutorial, this would be replaced by a picture later on, so we can't really use this. An alternative solution would also be to take this text and place it into a separate text box on a separate layer. So you create a layer here, and then actually to hide this layer and include the layer into your TOC. But today we want to solve the problems by using variables and the running header feature. The first thing we're going to do is to delete the Japan and the spacer, and we would need to do this on all pages. But before we do this, we're going to create a new paragraph style for this sushi. Just get a new here, and we call this one recipe. At the moment, the sushi has a character style applied, which gives it a color. We can remove this now, as all our headlines or recipe headlines will getting the same paragraph style, and we can include the color in this paragraph style. So in here, in character color, we can set this one again to red. Can click on OK. And now we would do this for all our recipe pages. Let's go to the next page. In here again, remove the Japan and the spacer. And to this, we're going to apply the recipe paragraph style. If you want, you can again get rid of the character style. Alright, if we now look at our headlines for the recipe pages, we see they all have the paragraph style recipe applied, and they all consist just of the recipe name that should get included into the TOC. However, now our design element with the country in front of here is missing. So let's see how we can get those back. We're going to go to the master pages, and we go to master A. In here, we want to create a new text box over here. So we take our text box tool and just drag it out. Next, we have to create some text variables. You can do this under type, text variables define. In here, we're going to create a new one for our recipes. Let's call this one recipe name. And in type, we're going to say running header based on the paragraph style. In here, we're going to select our paragraph style recipe and we say first on page. We can click on OK. Next, we need to create another variable, and this one is going to be for our pages in between where we have the country name sitting. And if we look here, all the country names on the pages in between have the paragraph style intro name applied. So we can use this to create another text variable. Again, we go on type, text variables, define, and in here we click on new again, and we're going to call this one country name. Again, this is going to be a running header based on the paragraph style, and we choose intro name as our paragraph style. We have again first on page selected. Click on OK and on done. Now let's move on to our master page again. And in here we're going to insert our two text variables. Right click and insert variable. Let's first insert the country name. Let's make this a little bit bigger. Then we insert a space and we press Alt 7 on our MacBook to insert this vertical symbol here. Press the space again and we're going to insert another variable, and this is going to be our recipe name. Now we can take a look at our pages and we see here it has included Japan and sushi. You see now this isn't really aligned very well. We can take care of this in the next step, but also you see it's black in the background, the sushi, so we should also remove the color of this text. We go back to Master A, and in here we select the recipe name and we remove the color by clicking on this symbol. Now it's basically colorless. To make this more centered and match with the rest of the text, we're going to select the text frame and click on this symbol, which will align it like the rest of the text. Let's go again to our recipe pages, and we see now we have the same effect as before, the same layout, but we have only the word rice in here. If we go now to our TOC, we can take advantage of this and include it. We can go on Layout, Table of Content Styles, and in here we're going to select Main TOC, we go on Edit, and we're going to remove the header and replace it by the paragraph style Recipe. Also you see here it gets the headline contents always included because it's sitting in here, but we have the headline already in here. So to remove this permanently, we're going to leave this title blank. We click on OK and on OK again, and then we can update our table of contents. Layout, update table of contents, and you see here, this looks quite nice. You would now need to adjust this a little bit, change the paragraph styles of the country headlines and the recipe headlines. So in the table of contents, we just can take a quick look at this again. We can go on Edit. You would need to make special paragraph styles for your entries. You could just go on New Paragraph Style and just play around a little bit. But we're not going to do this now. We have some other problems to take care of. For once, we have over here some problems, and we can fix this by assigning a new master page to the table of contents, where it just has the top one here blank, so nothing gets included over here. Next, if we see on our pages over here, we have the country names in here as a text box, but now we have the country names also as a text variable, so we could say we delete this one, and we delete this also on the other pages, like this. And we're going to include them now with the master page. We click on our master B, and in here we add a new text frame. Like this. And also we take the paragraph style header, and we're going to insert the variable for country name. If we now take a look at our pages, you see you have the country name right here, but you cannot edit this because it's on the master page. And if I would now go ahead and change the name of the country, maybe to China, it will get automatically updated on the pages in between, but also on all the recipe pages that come after this page here. So this is very practical to have. Also, if we go now on our table of contents and update it, you see that it gets also changed in here. And if you would like to know how to change the paragraph styles of your table of contents, I have already a basic video about table of contents that I will put at the end of the video. Alright, that's it for today. Don't hesitate to send in your own questions, and I will try to answer them, or maybe you get your own video. So, until next time, see you, bye bye!
With InDesign, it's really easy to create your table of contents. It's created automatically and can be customized very easily.
Can you hear the airplane? Let's wait a second. Go away!